Hello everyone, just doing a little catch-up video. Haven't been able to get any reviews out for a little while, mainly just down to amount of time with doing a new job at ASDA. Just haven't had the time, and also Christmas coming up, obviously there's all that as well. It's been taking up time doing shopping and that, so you have to forgive the fact I haven't done any videos for a little while. Obviously there is no sort of boot fairing activity this time of year anyway, so I haven't been doing any haul vids for that reason as well. I have picked up a couple of bits, and was actually given a couple of bits. I'll give you a quick look at what I've got. First thing is just one of these little robot heroes, I think they are. Just one of the little figures, which is Springer. I think it's supposed to be from like Dark of the Moon sort of line. Yeah, it's not bad, it's just one of those silly little figures. Pick that up for next to nothing. From the same shop, which deals in sort of second-hand toys, all sort of types and that, they're just getting random selection depending on what they come across over at toy fairs, boot fairs, or even people going in and sort of trying to make a bit of cash by selling them some old toys. I picked up another Star Wars Transformer. It's not complete, but it's not bad. I mean, for its actual robot mode, it doesn't really matter too much. And for the life of me, I can't remember what actual character name this guy is. I know it's one of the captains, I mean, or the clones, but it's from, I'd imagine, not Revenge, I'm thinking Revenge of the Sith. It might be Attack of the Clones, not sure, but it is the clone sort of like transport vehicle, like a juggernaut, I think they call it in the film. Yeah, it's a pretty good figure, bit kibbly, as most of the Star Wars ones are, but it's actually one of the better ones. It's got a few sort of like little hidden compartments and hidden weapons in the wheels. And it actually did have, and I assume that the kid who owned this originally never bothered to find this part, but it does actually have his little silver gun, which I would imagine is quite easily lost. And that just stores inside one of the wheels. And yeah, I was quite chuffed to find when I was having a look at it and opening it up that was still in there. So other than, I think there's an aerial and a little sort of like gun turret with a missile, he's complete. I mean, he is in very good nick, so I might find the parts and be able to complete it, but it'll fit in alright along the Star Wars line, along with like the Millennium Falcon and the Jedi Starfighters and that I've got. So that's really my only pickups as such. Now my nephew has been buying, well, he's pretty much brought all the Prime line, other than like the Cyberverse Legends size stuff. Yeah, he's pretty much brought all the deluxes, even some of the ones he's either got it on order and it's on its way, or he's already picked them up. Even some of the rarer things like Dreadwing in the Voyager size and that. And he brought a lot of Transformers off eBay, and because he's obviously brought a lot of Prime figures, he actually ended up with a double, which he gave to me, of RC, which is a pretty good figure. I won't go too much into it as such at the minute. I mean, the weird sort of backside with the sort of bee sting on the back is a little bit odd, but it's a pretty good figure. As all the Prime line are reasonably good, some are better than others. He really wanted this. Now you'll notice it hasn't got its bladed weapon now. He's a bit cheeky because he kept the bladed weapon, because now he's turned his one he's brought already into like a first edition RC, because now it's got two bladed weapons. So, but I don't mind. Now, I'll get back to this figure in a minute, because there is something else I want to discuss about it. Now, trying to think when it was now, last week, I did do a little job for him because he's brought so many figures that he had nowhere to put them. And in his bedroom, I went over and put up some shelves for him. And lo and behold, he'd been buying again. And he'd picked up another lot of second-hand Transformers. So he had a double. Now, the double he's given me is not complete. It's missing its weapons, but again, I'm not too fussed about that. I can always sort that out later. And it has got a little bit of damage, but if you're not pulling it about or transforming it, it doesn't make a difference. Not the most popular Transformer of this particular line, but I like it. And it's Transformers Ironhide. Now, I'm thinking this is from Armada. It's a super link sort of one where it can add on to like Jetfire and Prowl and that, I think. I don't know if they did it as well in that line. I'm a bit rusty on Armada and Energon and that. Yeah, not the greatest figure. His head with that great big thing at the back is a bit weird, to say the least. And I've transformed it a little bit differently than it's supposed to be because his legs are awful in his normal mode. So I've done it like the Super Link way. And I actually think he's actually better in proportion because his arms sort of come right to about the hips. And alright, his legs seem a bit longer, but I actually think that works better proportion-wise than the weird way it is when these are the other way up to form his legs. He looks too stumpy and fat, so I actually prefer transforming it that way. It's a matter of personal choice, I suppose. But yeah, I was quite chuffed. Just as I was doing the shells for him as a favour anyway, I didn't really expect anything in return, but he thought he'd give me another bot, something else I've got to find some space for. And eventually I will get my man cave, so another one I've got dust, which would be his problem now because he's got quite a lot out. One day I might coerce him to do a video on YouTube, never know. He's better on a computer than me, so it'd probably be better actually looking than mine. But then he's studying forensic computer science, so he should be better on the computer than me anyway. Anyway, getting back to RC from the Prime line. Now, where he had brought his Prime figures, and as you do, we all end up having a play and a transformation, see how they all sort of work and that. And also from where I've seen other people's reviews. Now, everyone's not too impressed about this weapon placement on the front wheel. Now, I'll quickly transform my RC, if anything else, just to prove that I do know how to do these Prime figures. And show you what I've sort of discovered. I'm just fiddling around with the figure. I will have some reviews coming up, by the way, once I get a little bit of time. There are a couple I want to get done, hopefully before Christmas, but I will get hopefully back to you on everyone on that. I'm desperately trying to fill in as I'm doing a bad job of transforming this figure. There we go. Now, as we're more or less at the stage I want to talk about, that will do. Now, that is of course the standard deluxe Bumblebee. Must have got him on the mind. Deluxe RC. Now, of course, as I said, everyone's not too impressed about sticking the weapon on the front forks of the bike because, and quite rightly, it looks stupid. Now, what I've discovered, rather than folding the arms in the way they're supposed to be like that, if you pull them out and revolve the forearm, now you can't peg it in quite the same as it originally is supposed to be, but when you close the fairing, they still snap into position and still then hold everything into the position you're putting it in. Now, once I've got this actually done, I'll show you what I'm on about. It's a little bit fiddly to start with, but it does work. Now, as you can see, if I bring that in, the arms are now that way up on the forearms, so that the holes are at the top, and you end up with the little silver bits on the forearms, sort of sticking out the top, almost like a little blade. And the hands are turned down behind the fairing. But because those holes are now on top, you can peg both. It will work with both weapons, but obviously, as I say, my nephew's got the bladed weapon for RC. You can actually fit the gun on top. So now RC can actually have her weapons on top in bike mode, which, alright, it would stop somebody riding the bike, but then this is a Transformer which is autonomous anyway, it doesn't really require anyone to be riding it. But yeah, so I thought I'd share that. I've not seen anyone else come up with that idea, and just in fiddling with it, I thought I'd sort of like found a way maybe that if anyone wants to display RC in a bike mode and still use the weapons in a bit more of a sensible way, it might well have solved a little issue for some people. So anyway, thought I'd show you that. And that's about it for the minute. I might even try and do a review after I finish filming and uploading this. So, with any luck, you might well get a review. A couple of people have mentioned, am I still even doing any filming? Rat Trap was, I think, the first one to ask. And Bumble Jumper. You forgive me if I haven't put the numbers in on your YouTube names, but it's, you know who you are. Anyway, thanks for watching this little vid. As I say, I'll try and get some reviews out as soon as I can. Still got plenty to review, loads of toys. And yeah, I shall see you again. Thanks for watching.